Thank you. Good afternoon, everyone. Good afternoon. Thank you for joining us both here in person and via the live stream option on the internet. My name is Tanya Sheldahl. I'm the Associate Vice President for Student Affairs and Dean of Students and proud Yavapai College alumna. Our ceremony will begin shortly, and just as a friendly reminder, now is a good time to silence or turn off your phones, please, during the ceremony. Once the processional music begins, you will first see Yavapai College leadership and faculty enter the auditorium from the front entrance. It actually looks like the back to us. And proceeding up the middle aisle toward the stage, leadership will be seated on the stage. Faculty will then be seated in the first few rows. Graduates will then enter the auditorium from each side. We are expecting over 300 graduates today. Yes, absolutely fabulous. As a courtesy to our graduates, please remain seated at the end of the ceremony until all graduates have exited the auditorium. Please, there are a lot of people here today. Thank you very much, everyone, and enjoy the ceremony.
53rd Annual Yavapai College Commencement Ceremony is now officially open.
The Star-Spangled Banner will be sung tonight by the Yavapai College Chamber Singers, conducted by Dr. Joshua Harper. Please rise and join us for the singing of our national anthem. And gentlemen, please remove your caps.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Dr. Diane Ryan. I am the Vice President for Academics. Welcome to this 53rd annual commencement of Yavapai College. Students and guests, please be seated. It is now my pleasure to introduce the members of the platform party who provide leadership and support for Yavapai College. Dr. Lisa Rhine, President of Yavapai College. Ms. Deb McCaslin, Yavapai College District Governing Board Member. Mr. Rodney Jenkins, Vice President for Community Relations and Student Development. Dr. Karen Palmer, Faculty Association President. The Honorable Mitchell J. Padilla, Justice of the Peace. Mr. Chris Cucneo, District Governing Board Member and Board Secretary. Mr. Ray Sigafoos, District Governing Board Member. Mr. Steve Brissetti, District Governing Board Member. Ms. Jamie Olterstorff, Student Speaker. Dr. Clint Ewell, Vice President for Finance and Administrative Services. Dr. Janet Nix, Chief Human Resource Officer. Ms. Marie Hardman, Allied Health Faculty. And Ms. Cami Kobaleski, Director of Development and Alumni Affairs. Please join me in recognizing these distinguished guests. And now, Will the faculty please stand so the graduates can acknowledge you one final time? Today marks a beginning for our students as they make the transition to the next phase of their lives and careers. They have achieved their goal, but they were not alone. They had you, friends, families, and classmates, to support and encourage them. So this afternoon, we also honor you. Those of you who have played a very meaningful part in the lives of those graduates. At this time, I would like to ask all the parents of our graduating students to stand and receive your well-deserved recognition. Parents? I would also like to recognize the spouses and the children of today's graduates. Spouses and children, please stand. And if there are any grandparents or great-grandparents in the audience and other friends and supporters of our graduates, please stand and be recognized. Congratulations to all of you. Now, it is my distinct pleasure to introduce the Honorable Mitchell J. Padilla, who will present our keynote address today.
Good afternoon. I'd like to begin by saying thank you to Dr. Ryan, the Executive Board, and the Governing Board for the opportunity to address our graduates today. But before I begin, I want to kind of clear something up. As your Justice of the Peace, one of the questions that I get asked every day almost is, what else do you do besides marry people? And I thought about that. So there is actually quite a bit more that I do. As your Justice of the Peace, I have my courtroom, which is over at the Prescott Courthouse at the Square. But I have a lot of other duties, and I deal with a lot of issues as well. So for example, issues like arguments between friends, dogs that bark, curfew violations, dogs that bite, speed racing in the streets of our community, dogs that stray, and of course, even the occasional individual that is evading law enforcement. I will tell you, though, that usually doesn't end too well. Nonetheless, it's a pretty good job. I'm having a good time. I meet all kinds of people. And at the end of the day, literally at the end of the day, yes, I do weddings. So, with that said and cleared up, let's get started. Today, I stand before you in one of the most revered settings that one could hope to experience, and that's graduation from college. Isn't it wonderful being on the road of personal accomplishment? How satisfying this evening you'll have a chance to sit down, relax, exhale, and think to yourself, I did it. I found a way. You might even ask yourself the question, what should I do next? So you see, life is a wonderful road of adventure if you want it to be. You will experience and overcome challenges. You'll run into roadblocks and find ways to get around them. And you will feel the pain of disappointment and the joy of overcoming that. And all of these experiences are going to shape you as you continue to move forward through your lives. So what I want to touch on today are two things that I believe are very, very important, and they are to me. It's hope and inspiration. I believe that these two things are necessary for us to live our dreams and reach our goals. So what is hope? Hope can be described as a desire accompanied by the expectation of or the belief in fulfillment. And inspiration can be described as the feeling of enthusiasm that you receive from someone or something that gives you new and creative ideas. Now, you found hope within yourselves. It's one of the reasons why you're here. And someone or something inspired you to begin your journey. Now, does your journey end today? Does it take a pause? Does it continue on? You will be letting us know soon, I'm sure. Personally, I have faced many challenges on my own journey through life. I've run into roadblocks and walls along the way. Some of those I placed there myself. On more than one occasion, I lacked confidence in myself and in my abilities, and I'd ask myself, can I really do this? You may have asked yourself that very same question a time or two along the way. I was not a traditional student. Like many of you, I was a first-generation college student, and all of my education came as a part-time student at night while I worked full-time during the day. I took out student loans for every degree that I pursued, and I found a way to pay them all back. And having gone through these experiences, what I realized was that I can do it. I did it. And so will you. One of everyone's biggest concerns is the cost of education. And it should be. Many of you sitting here today know exactly what I'm talking about. You may have questions. How will I pay for school? How will I pay back a student loan if I have to take one? And really, a very big question is it really going to be worth it? There are answers to these for costs. Investigate and determine what those costs are. Meet with financial aid representatives, develop your plan, and stick to it. And as far as student loans go, don't be afraid of student loans. Use them if you need to. Just don't take more than you need, or that loan may itself turn into a roadblock for other goals that you have in your life. And will it be worth it? Only you will know if it is worth it. However, the knowledge and experience that you gain through the personal commitments that you make will bring you a tremendous sense of pride in your accomplishments, and that is what builds confidence. Now, here is something to think about. The value of education for someone other than yourself. There will come a day, and you will look back on your life, and you'll think about your accomplishments, and you should know that not only were they important to you, but they were important to someone else around you. You are role models, whether you recognize that or not. And someone is looking up to you today to see how you made it and why you chose the path you took. And because you are role models, your actions and accomplishments can reinforce someone else's hope in their own future and provide the inspiration that they will need to begin their own journeys of personal accomplishment. So, graduates, I'm going to leave you with these final words. Your lives are what you make of them. You are not perfect, and if you pursue perfection, you need to understand you're going to come up a little bit short in the end. However, if you continue to pursue perfection, perhaps, just perhaps, you will still find excellence in what you do. My best wishes to all of you today. May your paths forward be one of excitement and personal accomplishment. Thank you.
Thank you, Judge Padilla. The Yavapai College faculty have guided these graduates through their academic coursework and prepared them well. I am now pleased to introduce Ms. Marie Hardman, who will address the graduates on behalf of the faculty.
Good afternoon. Tenacity. I have tenacity. Growing up in Maine, I graduated top 10 in my high school class. All my friends went off to college. My teachers did not understand why I was not going to college. I told them college was not a conversation in my house. Instead, I went to work. At age 26, I decided I want to go to college. I earned a bachelor's degree and became a registered nurse. I have not stopped learning since then. Why do I teach? Growing up, my teachers provided me with more positive feedback than my parents. I came to enjoy participating in school and school activities. It felt like home. When I reflect on my childhood experiences, it does not surprise me that I became a teacher. I love learning. When students are engaged and respond with enthusiasm, I become their cheerleader. I teach to encourage students to explore in a safe environment. I teach adults because their rich histories provide a jumping-off point to further their education. My passion is to inspire people. In 2001, when I finished my master's degree in adult education, I visited Arizona on vacation. I drove all around Arizona, and when I drove into downtown Prescott, I said, "This is beautiful, and it reminds me of Maine." Before I left town, I went to the Yavapai College and Mission Building and picked up a brochure. There I saw they offered a nursing program. I thought, someday I will move here and teach at the community college. 8 years later, and waist high in snow, I found a nurse instructor position on the Yavapai College website. Then I knew. Moving to Arizona was in my immediate future. 4 short months later, I had quit my nursing job, sold my massage business, sold my house, and drove across the country. I began teaching first-year nurses in the nursing program, then transferred to Allied Health and taught nursing assistants and medical assistants. My teaching goal was to support and motivate students. Working for Yavapai College has helped me grow as a person. I was the faculty advisor for the HOSA Club and the chair for the Peer Faculty Mentor Committee for several years. While at Yavapai College, I mentored many new faculty. My 14-year career at Yavapai College has flown by. My teaching time was not like work because I loved what I did. Every day when I left my house, I wasn't going to work, I was going to school. Graduates, find work you love, because that makes all the difference. What I would like to impart to the Yavapai College graduates and everyone here today is trust your intuition. You never know where you may end up. Focus your sights on your goal and be resilient enough to jump on the opportunity when it appears. Graduates, be tenacious. Believe in yourself. The sign that hung on my wall in my office says it all. From Henry David Thoreau. Go confidently in the direction of your dreams. Live the life you have imagined. Thank you.
Thank you, Marie. Since this ceremony celebrates student achievement, we are now honored to hear from our student speaker, Ms. Jamie Olsterstorf.
Welcome, distinguished guests, administrators, professors, family, friends, and members of the class of 2023. I am honored and humbled to address you on behalf of my graduating class. My name is Jamie Olsterstorf, and I am graduating again, but this time with a degree in fine arts. Like many of my fellow graduates, I didn't start my college experience in this major or at this college. I began this journey a long time ago in 2007 at a small college in Ashland, Kentucky. I started out as a criminal justice major. A semester in, I joined the Air Force and became a law enforcement officer, also known as security forces. My college was put on hold for quite some time. I took classes in between deployments, but in my entire military career, I didn't earn an associate's. My family and I moved to Yavapai County in 2018 after my retirement from the military. College was still not a priority, my family was, and helping contribute to our household. I bounced in and out of jobs until I finally landed here at Yavapai College. College was finally an option for me. I registered for classes in the fall of 2019 and came in as a business major, but guess what? It changed. It took a major event in my life in 2020 to help me discover what I want to be when I grow up. You see, my husband and I were expecting what a joy that was going to be until it wasn't. We discovered we were having conjoined twins, which is a 1 in 500,000 chance. 53 minutes, that was their lifespan that they laid on my chest. All they knew was love, and all I needed was a release. I found that release here at Yavapai College in an art class. Thank you. I was once told by a very inspiring individual that if you can tell your story without crying, you made it. Clearly, my journey is not over. As I said before, my degrees changed. My degrees of choice are an Associate of Arts with an emphasis in psychology, an Associate of Arts in Fine Arts, and now my journey has led me to take the new bachelor's degree program with a concentration of organizational management and leadership. Thank you. The end goal is to be an art therapist so I can help people as those classes help me. We have all faced adversity in our lives, but look at us now. Life may give each of us different circumstances or situations, but what truly makes us all the same? In the words of William Ernest Henley, we are all masters of our fate and captains of our souls. All of us have our own destinies to write. It is up to us on how we choose to write, how we choose to use our minds and our hearts to get to where we want to be and to become the person we want to be. While it is certainly true that many things have gone wrong in the past few years, it is also true that many things have gone right. We are here today to accept one of those things that went just right. I will end this with a quote from Stephen King. Right now, we have the power to do great good for others and ourselves. So I ask you to begin the next great phase of your life by giving and to continue as you begin. I think you'll find in the end that you got far more than you ever had and did more good than you ever dreamed of. Congratulations, class of 2023, and good luck with your future endeavors. Thank you.
Thank you, Jamie. That was absolutely beautiful. We will now enjoy the performance of This Is Me, performed by the Yavapai College Chamber Singers and conducted by Dr. Joshua Harper.
To the dark, hide away, they say, 'cause no one will want your broken parts. I've learned to be ashamed of all my scars. Run away, they say, 'cause no one will love you as you are. But
I won't let them break me down to dust. I know that there's a place for us, for we are sharpest lies wanna cut me down. I'm gonna send a flood, gonna drown them out. I am brave, I am Bruce, I am who I'm meant to be. This is me. Look out, 'cause here I come. And I'm marching on to the beat I drum. I'm not scared to be seen. I make no apologies.
Oh,
It is now my distinct pleasure to present these men and women who are graduating this afternoon. I ask the president of Yavapai College, Dr. Lisa Rhine, and Ms. Deb McCaslin, the district governing board chair, to please join me at the podium. Announcing the graduates' names will be Lisa Ragoza, director of our Hispanic community outreach, and assisted by Tanya Sheldahl, associate vice president of student affairs and dean of students. Each of the graduates will be crossing the stage from the audience's right to left. Will the degree and certificate candidates please stand? Dr. Rhine and Ms. McCaslin, I present to you the Yavapai College Class of 2023.
By virtue of the power and authority vested in me by the Constitution and laws of the State of Arizona, I now confer upon you the degree or certificate for which you have qualified, with all the rights, privileges, and responsibilities thereunto pertaining. Congratulations, and students, please be seated.
The first graduate group, Associate of Arts. Hope Elizabeth Olson. Grace Ann M. Olson. Marcus Wynn. David Waters. Catherine Verlindy. Eleanor Reckmeyer. Thomas Yule.
So there's going to be a green dot in the top left corner when you look in there. That means it's in focus.
Stephanie Culver. Thank you. Danielle Holquist. Abigail Boyd. Latisa Stamper. Keith Dummermuth. Caleb Espino. Anthony Juarez. Ashley Hayden. Jordan Westcott. Harley Groves. Wendy Herrera. Anya Mills. Sophie Parkinson. Justin Patton. Savannah Baker. Tiffany Black. Jillian Nagel. Brindavan Silva. Ileana Oberlander. Amanda Borja. Rennie Christensen. Jordan Jones Wormser. Jamie Ulstersdorf. Destiny Munoz. Miriam Zabibu. Gabrielle Garrow. Anne Robeson. Hannah Utaro. Isabella Marino. Daniela Mares. Emma Alvarez. Ashlyn Jones. Alice Bartmettler. Desiree Pitt. Riley Bremer. Emily Cunningham. Eileen Palacios. Allie Mullins. Dylan Harvey. Trevor Andersch. Tyler Cloyd. Taylor Smith. Sophie Maxwell Trott. Ananda Walker. Mariah Kelly Jones. Yanis Pasudias. Kathleen Dahlstrom. Naomi Gittens. Destiny Gilpin. Ryan Anderson. Jennifer Leiben. Sadie Allred. Michael Pearson. Caleb Owings. Emily Carroll. Angela McCary. Sophia Tomcho. Haley Silvernail. Serenity Nickel. Paige Huxall. Rowan Jackson. Marina Garcia. Brooklyn Knievel. Destiny Lobato. Shelby Thompson. Jaden Rummage. Lorena Martinez. Nora Wickman. Simona Paulson. Jack M. Williams. Joshua J. Favors. Melissa M. Soto. Michaelina D. Manuel. Dana Torrens. Morgan Cooper. Danielle Stegman. Angelique Ajay. Aslan Kumbera. Caitlin Schroeder. Jacob J. Christie. Ashley Gardikas. Aurelia Formoso. Rain Brombach. Kaylee Span. Michael O'Connell. The last person of the Associate of Arts graduate is Don Camello. Excuse me, Carmen Don Camello. Next graduate group, Associates of Business. Skylar Becker. Rebecca Schroeder. Dejanisi Azevedo. Juan Lozada. Sierra B. King. Brandon Devon. Jonathan Tavares. Crystal Clark. Alondra Larez. The last person with Associates of Business is Benzi Yonner. Our next graduate group, Associates of Science, Cynthia Ramos. Keenan Hammock. Emma Rubash. Michal Moshish. Alyssa San Agustin. Aiden Scotch. Olivia Tiwari. This is the last Associate of Science graduate. Lily Stein. Our next graduate group, Associates of General Studies, Serena Beard. Rebecca Gonzalez. Paige Caswell. Jordan Lajanis. Tanya Uchida. Isaiah Wagner. Nayeli Jones. Janelle Mizell. Genevieve Espinoza. Rakina Curtis. Angelina De Leon. Kobe Mador. Mandel Campbell. Walter Talley. Amanda Davies. Jaden Ferris. Jose Vega. Elijah Rollins. Dylan Priebus. Anastasia Lobo. Morgan Ingleby. Jason Maza. The last Associate of General Studies. Riley Hoskins. The next graduate group, Associates of Applied Science. Natalia Hagnisi. Carson Villalobos. Joanna Ledesma. Robin Dixon. Agustina Alemán. Shannon Johns. Jamie Dodwell. Anita Lehman. Alicia Montoya. Tammy Brockett. Crescenda Koyekwaptiwa. Michael Doherty. Yeah. Laura Warney. Kato Fujimoto. Candace Gorski. Zoe Harmon. Tristan Horner. Jason Weiss. Austin Tosh. Evan Ziegler. John Bruce. Michael Martin. Hannah Moffitt. Richard Yazzie. Claren Rowe. Ivy Chamberlain. Roman Selick. Rebecca Somerville. Nicole Welker. Abigail Mendoza Pina. Mackenzie Yarbrough. Tyler Kirking. Matthew Arvo. Sandra Hotman. Michelle Diaz. Victoria Janu Marie Burns. Gina Turi. Yadira Bautista Burgos. Diana Cardoza. Guadalupe Ocampo. Ryan Davies. Juliana Camholz. Sierra McDonald. Victoria Winsberg. Andrea Torres. Megan Palmer. Alexander Hoskins. Trevor Hinkle. Rachel Gudetti. Ty Schroeder. Uriah Richards. Sarah Tippett. Michaela Schilling. Madison Ward. Lindsay Jones. Amanda Hoff Felix. Kara Yazzie. Emily Harkus. Bianca Miller. Trevor Gardner. Elijah Valdivieso. Lita Warfield. Christian Lawson. Destiny Lewis. Carly Drentlaw. Zerion Carlson. Jacob Schoen. Gabrielle Porter. Ariel Allen. Catherine Kendrick. Gage Rigetti. Chance Hill. Richard Almond. Dawson Gillen. The last Associate of Applied Science graduate is Benjamin Fry. Final graduate group of certificates. Julia Paulson. Alyssa Sign Harvey. Chance Rosas. Cameron Pippen. Caleb Dinwiddie. Crystal Ogden. Mary Ellis Navarez. Ruby Cardoza. Eden Mendoza. Leia Keppel. Maria Ocampo Guarda. Amir Ruby Ayala. Marshall Minear. Julian Ramirez. Christopher Pauly. Melinda Marie Doherty. Madeline Hart. Woo, 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 woo.
Danny Avalar. Cecilia Villa. Leanne Ford. Emma Otten. Fernando Soto. Gabriel Castaneda. Nathan Porter. Lana Colgrove. Cassandra Morrison. Emma Johnston. Mitchell Shoemaker. Jasmine Keith. Kaylee Keeler. Jessica Cardell Kennedy. Catherine Zuniga. Isabel Varela. Brianne Waldie. Krista Ferguson. Cody Hall. Brian Torres. Vanessa Ballard. Cheyenne Thompson.
Marion Gill.
Elva Marion Gill. Caleb Tarter. Lucian Liss. Matthew Kuhn. Quentin Uridil. Seth Angel. Abraham Laura. Peter Nachi. Kian Litchfield. Jesus Cepeda. Nina Compton. Deegan Owings. Matthew Wilkerson. Matthew Twitchell. Jan Karstanian. Jeffrey Shoemate. Michael Link. Joshua Finesse. Zachary Scully. William Good. Martin Villalobos. Dawson Cowan. Carson Ramirez. Reeves Pendleton. Roy Frias. Dylan Horst. Caleb Parton. Joshua Parton. Logan Hawks. Julianne Kuntzman. Kyle Bills. Diego Perez. Jason Lanier. Maria Perry. McIntosh. Norberto Sanchez. Erica O'Brien. Leo Vega. Connor Ransom. Juan Carlos Figueroa Nunez. Jamal James. Travis DiDomenico. Don Munoz. Moises Hernandez. Chancellor Haugen. Casey Hartsock. Eduardo Chacon. Trevor Huber. Eric Gomez Beltran. Carlos Rodriguez. Eric Ayala. Lindsay McKenzie. Skyler Harn. Cooper Hall. Shalane Gorman. Damian Wimmer. Markeisha Rivenburr. Rosa Hyatt. Amelia Ehrlich. Caden McMains. Mason Evans. Paige Johnson. Abigail Alvarado. Jocelyn Seisinger. McLean Donovan. Evelyn Rodriguez. Bianca Phillips. Rudy Kosak. Briseis Lemons. Lisbeth Romero Rios. Mia Alizaga. Priscilla Escareño. Lahia Fajardo. Shannon Murphy. Gracie Duenes. Mariah Lofton. Gracie Davidson. Braden Gotch. Caleb Perchett. Daisy Hernandez Moreno. Jacob Witusik. Andrew Sweeney. James McPherson. Rhett Latham. And our last certificate graduate, Austin Martin.
As a college president, there isn't any other day that is more special, more exhilarating, or more fulfilling than Commencement Day. For those of us in higher education, this is the biggest event of the year. It's where we see the fruits of our labor and our mission fulfilled. And for all of our students and those that love them, it's a day where all of your hard work, perseverance, and sacrifice have paid off. Graduates, this day is about you and dreams realized. Never let it be said that dreaming is a waste of one's time. For dreams are our realities in waiting. In dreams, we plant the seeds of our future. Dreams motivate and inspire. Dreams cause us to persevere under difficult circumstances, and dreams create a focus in our lives. Dreams are realized at community colleges. The beautiful thing about the community college is the diversity in age and types of the students that attend. Our youngest graduate this year is Joshua Parton. He was born in 2007. Joshua is 15 years old and resides in Paulden. Joshua has completed his automotive technician certificate. Our oldest graduate is Carol Ann Chambers. She lives in Cottonwood, and she was born in 1938. Carol Ann is 84 years old. She completed her Associate of Arts degree and her Arizona General Education Certificate A. I had the chance to meet her yesterday. She's continuing on for her bachelor's degree in business at Yavapai College. In fact, Yavapai College has 120 graduates that are under the age of 18 this year, and we have 36 graduates that are over the age of 55. We have two siblings that are celebrating their accomplishments today. Big brother Caleb Owings is completing our Northern Arizona Regional Training Academy for law enforcement officers, while his younger brother, Deegan Owings, has earned his certificate in structural welding. Will Caleb and Deegan please stand and let us recognize you. We have a mother-daughter team graduating today, too, Diana and Ruby Cardoza. Mom, Diana, is receiving her associate degree in nursing, while daughter Ruby is receiving her nursing assistant certificate. Will Diana and Ruby please stand? Let us celebrate you. This year, we started an early college academy with Prescott High School. Students in high school took their final year of high school classes with us at Yavapai College and received dual credit. Our first two graduates will both receive their associate's degrees today before they are awarded their high school diplomas later this month. They are Eleanor Reckmeyer and Thomas Yule. Eleanor and Thomas, stand and let us recognize you. Yavapai College has been recognized as a veteran-friendly campus, serving on average 265 veterans and dependents of veterans each semester. We proudly salute, thank, and welcome home those that have served in the armed forces. Will all veterans, dependents, or spouses of a veteran, or those actively serving in the U.S. Armed Forces, please stand and be recognized. We thank you for your sacrifice and service. Also, if you're a first responder, a nurse, an emergency medical technician, you work in the hospital, you work in law enforcement or fire, please stand and let us thank you for your public service and the risks you take every day to ensure the safety and well-being for all of us. We are forever thankful. Community colleges are proud providers of opportunity. Many of our students are the first in their families to go to college, and I'm a proud first-generation college student myself. If you're the first one in your family to go to college, please stand and be recognized. Education unlocks opportunity, and you've taken a big step forward to increase educational attainment in your family, and you serve as a role model for generations that follow. All of our graduates have a dream, but they also have a story. Stephanie Culver has a story. She's a third-generation Prescottonian and first-generation college student. She moved away from Prescott at age 19 with the call to live in a big city. She lived in Pasadena, Austin, Los Angeles, and then even London, England. As part of a youth organization in London, she worked to spread awareness for domestic violence against women and was involved with organizations that helped to rescue women and children from human trafficking. But in 2016, she returned to Prescott to care for her grandparents, both whom had cancer. After her grandfather passed, she found out that her grandmother had dementia, and Stephanie cared for her until she passed in 2020. Then Stephanie found her 40-year-old self stuck and in a dark place. She enrolled at Yavapai College, and despite some serious setbacks with COVID hospitalizations, she made it through with the help of her advisors and her professors. In her sophomore year, she decided to apply and was accepted into Yavapai College's Students of Leadership and found many kindred spirits and got to meet YC leaders. She says that soul leaders poured themselves into the students, meeting them at their level, and made her feel part of something bigger. Before that, she said she felt lost. She said that Yavapai isn't just an institution, it's where you can find yourself and be encouraged to reach your dreams, regardless of your age. Her dream is to finish her undergraduate degree through the 90-30 program with NAU, and then return to England in hopes to get her master's and doctorate at Cambridge. And I'm sure she's going to achieve that. Stephanie, if you're here, please stand. Let us recognize you. Danny Avalar has a story. Danny's story is one of a high school dropout who was raised in a household where education was not the number one concern, providing for the family was. Both his mother and father do not possess formal education. They were immigrants raised in an impoverished environment, and they worked really hard to survive and to become successful restaurateurs with a successful business of more than 15 years and still going. But their journey, sacrifice, and continuous support pushed him through the finish line. Danny says he had an opportunity that his parents never got to have. Fast forward to the summer of 2018, and he signed up for the LEAD program 10 minutes before the midnight deadline in what he believes was a one-year stay at Yavapai College to earn his certification as a firefighter and EMT that transformed into something else. He's been blessed with the opportunity to be a student with this institution for 5 years now, earning his associate's degree, majoring in fire science education, getting his Arizona General Education Curriculum Certificate, countless FEMA certifications, becoming a member of Students of Leadership, and opportunities to serve as a Senate representative in the Student Government Association and as treasurer on the executive team. He says the last 5 years have given him purpose, have given him a reason to live, and to make those who have supported him and believed in him proud. He's now blessed with the opportunity to earn his bachelor's degree here at the institution that gave him a second chance at life. What a remarkable success story, my friend. Danny, please stand and let us recognize you. Fernando Antonio Soto has a story. Fernando is the youngest of three siblings. He lives with his mom in Chino Valley, who's a single parent raising three boys while running a daycare out of her home. Fernando was approached his junior year about enrolling in the fire science program through CTED. He kept a 3.14 GPA while working 34 hours a week at Cow Ranch Warehouse and finishing his high school at Chino Valley High. Fernando reported that his brothers both finished high school, but he will be the first one to graduate from college. He credits his success to his instructors for supporting him and his mom for always being there for him and instilling a great work ethic. His ultimate goal is to get his Associate of Applied Science in Fire Science, and today Fernando earned his Firefighting Basic Certificate. Fernando, please stand and let us recognize you. Desiree Aisha Pitt has a story. Desiree's journey at Yavapai College began over 20 years ago. At 17, she started at YC by getting her GED through Yavapai's excellent night prep classes and taking two courses before moving out of the area at 18. As her life took its twists and turns, her family returned to the Quad City area. Fast forward to the spring of 2021, and she found herself as a Teacher of the Year banquet honoring top educators in the district. She sat listening to students talk about their teacher's influence, and she thought, I want to have an impact and help students to reach their potential. The next day, she enrolled in Yavapai College's Associates in Elementary Education program, and she says that going back to school at 36, a wife, a mother of two teenagers, and full-time employee, and a public education advocate, feels like riding a bike as the bike is on fire, speeding downhill. But since that first class, she knew she'd made the right choice to attend YC. She's been encouraged on her journey by excellent teaching staff, the ever-helpful advising staff, and her classmates. Earning the Gardner Family and YC Foundation scholarships are two proud moments for her. With the generosity of the community and an extensive support system, she was able to buckle down and get her degree in 2 years. Graduation day is one she's looked forward to for many years, and she can't wait to see what the future holds. She's thankful to Yavapai College for showing her that she can reach her goals and never stop learning, no matter how old or young one may be. Desiree has completed her Associate of Arts in Elementary Education. Desiree, please stand. Let us recognize you. Tiffany Black has a story. Tiffany is a wife and mother to 3 boys. During a literature class, she met Professor Denise Woolsey and learned about the College Honors Program. And she thought, no way could she add that to her plate. But she also learned that it was about leadership, and she said, that's not me. She was accepted and found many resources that were available and realized that she didn't have to go through this journey alone. She found encouragement every step of the way and pushed herself outside of her comfort zone with the motivation and support of fellow students, staff, and faculty, and found that she could even take on a role as a leader in a club and PTK. And she says, at Yavapai College, I feel like I belong. Tiffany graduates today with an Associate of Arts and is rolling in our nursing degree program in the fall of 2023. Tiffany, please stand and be recognized. Dana Torrens has a story. Dana is a full-time student and a full-time teacher and a mother of 5 children. With some serious personal setbacks and losses, she describes that her time at YC has been some of the best and worst couple of years for her. She says without her family's support and her YC instructors, Professors Winters, Walk, Stein, and Fillingham, and her advisor Ashley Burkhart's support, she doesn't know if she would be graduating today. She's honored to have such an astounding support team within Yavapai College, and she now knows that she can do anything if she pushes through the rough and keeps her aspirations alive. Dana graduates today with an Associate of Arts in Elementary Education. Dana, please stand and let us recognize you. Throughout your educational journey, all of you have found the strength to persevere under trying circumstances. What we now know about ourselves is that no matter what challenges may come our way, we have the strength to prevail. I can't tell you what you will confront in the years ahead, but I can tell you that no matter what you confront, it will not outstrip your capacity to deal with it. To all the dreamers here today, the college salutes you and wants you to know that Yavapai College has been blessed by your presence and engagement with us, and we are humbled and proud to be part of your personal story. And now, graduates, would you please stand? The certificate or degree that you have earned signifies that you have now joined the ranks of tens of thousands of individuals who have been educated in the American higher education tradition. I now invite you to officially move your tassel from the right side to the left side. Signifying that you can now claim title to the academic credential that you have earned. Congratulations, it's official, graduates. You have reached your goal. You may be seated. It's now my pleasure to introduce Ms. Cami Kobolewski, the Director of Development and Alumni Affairs.
Thank you, Dr. Ryan. Are you all ready to get out and celebrate? I'm it, I promise, and it's so short. On behalf of the Office of Alumni Affairs, I want to congratulate and welcome you as the newest Yavapai College alumni. You now belong to a group of over 165,699 people who have benefited from their educational pursuits here at Yavapai College. And I'm going to go a little off script because Chair McCaslin and YC alumna said yesterday, wouldn't it be really great if everyone who has a certificate or a degree from Yavapai College would stand to be acknowledged? So any staff, faculty, or people in the audience, if you've received a certificate or a degree from YC, will you please stand so we can give you all a round of applause? So amazing to see you all here celebrating our newest graduates. We wish you great success as you enter this next phase of your life. The education received at Yavapai College has equipped each of you to lead, to prosper, and to be agents of change in a global society. At YC, we believe that you can. You can achieve, you can succeed, and as you soar, we want you to stay connected with us. So remember, your dream started here. We hope to see you at some of our events, like Alumni Reunion Weekend in September, and to stay connected with us on social media. Also, stay in touch through our alumni webpage, where we can't wait to hear and share your success and Where Are They Now stories. You carry with you the spirit of Yavapai College. Welcome, alumni, and congratulations on this amazing achievement.
This marks the end of our 53rd commencement event. Thank you all for attending today. Audience, please remain seated until all graduates have left the auditorium. Best wishes to all of you, and keep dreaming.